Hi everybody, welcome to NuttX channel. As you know, the STM32F4 discovery board doesn't have the Ethernet connector. So if you want to use the Ethernet, we need to buy the STM32 baseboard to plug this board over it, or you can use RNDIS, the Ethernet over USB, to get Ethernet connection. Today I will show how to do that. I will divide this tutorial in two parts. In this first part, I will show how to use Telnet to get access to NSH terminal and send some commands and so on. And in the next part, I will show how to transfer files from the computer to the board. So let's get started. Open the Linux terminal. Enter inside NuttX space, NuttX, execute make disk clean to clear previous configuration. We need to select more than 15 options to get the Ethernet over USB working. I wrote down some tips here to avoid some issues, to forget some options. So we can start the board configuration, execute tools, configure.sh stm32f4 discover / nsh. We can execute make menu config to enable the options to get the Ethernet over USB working. Enter inside builder setup, change the build host platform from Windows to Linux. Enter inside system type, STM32 peripheral support, enable USB OTG full speed support, exit again. Go to RTOS features, work queue support, enable high priority kernel work thread, exit again. Go to networking support, enable networking support, enter in link layer support, enable local loopback, exit. Enter inside socket support, enable socket options, exit. Go to TCP/IP networking, enable it. Also enable TCP/IP write buffering to improve the network performance, exit. Go to UDP networking, enable it. Also enable UDP broadcast RX support to receive broadcast message from the network. Now go to ICMP networking support, enable it to get the ping working. Go to ARP configuration, enable ARP send. Exit. Enable collect network statistics. And that's all for the networking support. Now we can go to application configuration. Enter inside network utilities. Enable Telnet daemon here. We can exit. Go to NSH library, enable have architecture specific initialization, enter inside networking configuration, enable network initialization thread. Inside the IP address configuration, here we have the IP address coded in hexacode, so the target address is 10 .0.0.2. And the router, it will be our computer in this case, is 10.0.0.1. Select the hardware has no MAC address, because we need to define a MAC address to get the Ethernet working. We can use this default address. Exit. Go to Telnet configuration just to verify if all options are enabled. Okay. Now we can leave these options. Leave again. And go to device drivers. And enable network device support. Okay, the Telnet driver is enabled. It is used to create a device file to let applications to communicate with the network protocol in the NuttX. So we can exit and move down to USB device driver, enable it and enter inside it. And enable RNDIS Ethernet over USB. Enable this option as well. Exit. Exit again. Enter inside board selection. And enable USB device controls. Exit. Exit again. And save. Execute make to compile the source code. The source code was compiled. Now we can flash the firmware inside the board. Ctrl R, open OCD. Press Enter to flash the firmware. Okay, the firmware was flashed in the board. Now we can plug the micro USB cable in the board. Reset the board. And as you can see, the Ubuntu starts to assign an IP address to the board, but we need to define it manually. So you click in Wired Connection, clicking Edit, IPv4 Settings, change to manual, clicking add, and type 10.0.0.1. Press enter and save it. Can close, remove the USB cable and plug it again. Okay, now it got IP. We can verify if the board is replying ping 10.0.0.2. Okay, the board is responding. We can press Ctrl C and we can execute Telnet to the board 10.0.0.2. Okay, we get access to the NuttShell. Now we can execute some commands. Hello from NuttX. And see all the commands existent in the board. So basically that is it. I hope you had enjoyed this video. If you are not subscribed to the NuttX channel, please subscribe and click in the bell icon to receive notifications when I post a new video. And see you in the next video. Bye bye.